Hello and welcome to Middle Age Geek Girl. I'm Sally. It's that time of the month again, which I really regret saying every time I say that sentence. I'm talking about completed projects and colouring pages for the month of April 2024. We are already a third of the way through the year. My goodness. So let's check out what I've got. I've definitely got my mojo back. So my slump of January and February has definitely gone, which is a wonderful thing. Also, I think being on the proper dose of dexamphetamine is helping as well. Not that I'm promoting drugs, but if you know, when you have ADHD and they take so long in your life to diagnose it and then finally put you on the medication you need for it, it's amazing what you can achieve. Having said that, let's move on. So here are two diamond paintings I completed for the month of April. Now, I still have one pending, which of course is Jack the Cat. I have worked on it a little bit more, but I've got to work on it in small doses because, as I've mentioned in previous videos, it is so confetti heavy and it drives me nuts if I do it for too long. But these two were really quite simple and cute little diamond paintings to do, and I have got videos on the channel doing these and with a little bit of a chat. So check out those videos if you're interested in the speed drilling and also the little bit of a chat, but they're really quite cute little pieces. So they were the two diamond paintings I got done. Now I also got done, which I don't have to show here, but there are again videos on my channel to show the building. I completed three Loz kits. Two were the street mini of the Japan street, so that completed the four in that street set. So check out those videos. And the third one I haven't actually shown yet. It won't be shown till, I think it's due to release on the 11th of May, and that is building Luna, Sailor Moon's cat from Sailor Moon. And that one, yeah, as I said, I haven't shown yet, but that one will be available on the 11th. So I did three of those, and I did one miniature room, which I have also shown on the channel, and that was one of the Row Life Super Creator, the bookshop I did. So again, that video was there. So very, very, very busy. And I did a 24 colouring pages. So a number of them were colour by numbers, but they're still being coloured in, so you know, 24 is still good for me. And they're from books I want to finish in 2024. So we'll check out this one first, and it's the Stone Mosaics book one, and I did four from here, and I used a mixture of alcohol markers and water-based markers. It's really just whatever markers I have to hand. And in the case of the alcohol markers on these ones, it's the old pack. I'm still trying to use up some of the actual pens. And so the colours might not be exact as per what the number is, but they're a close proximity of what they need to be. So you've got this nice little house garden. You've got this one, which I believe is some flowers in a... Oh yeah, I can see it now. When I colour them in, sometimes I can't work it out. But it's obviously flowers in a vase, and that's your bottle of water, and just some mosaic work in the tiles. This one, you have a jug and some fruit. And this one is a guitar with its shadow leaning up against a wall with some musical notes. So yeah, quite cool, I think. And of course, when I colour them in, I'm doing it backwards so that you don't lose your detail here of what the colours should be. I think I've only got about, oh, that might actually be it, the finished book. Have I finished this book? Certainly looks like it. I have. Wow, yay! I've actually finished one of my books for the year. Very happy with that one. Now, this one I did three and I forgot to mention what it is. It is the horror and nightmare creatures from Color Questopia. And I did three. With these ones, I sort of just do the background as I want. It does give you an idea of the colors. And this one, I thought I would just use two of the colors it had suggested and do a little bit of a pattern. But you've got like this, I don't know, fleshy skull creature man thing in there. This is a weird book. Some of them look are from movies, like I can identify the characters, and others I have no idea. Again, you've got a skull with two hands, and I did the same sort of thing. I just picked one of the colors it suggested for the background and just did it all in that color. And same background thing I did for it, and the monster. Now, again, I have mentioned it in other videos. I'm not too fond of these Color Questopia books. Nothing against them. They're just not for me. I mean, I do like the black background ones. I think it adds a bit more. But yeah, this book I'm not that fond of, but I want to finish it. It's one of those things. I'm almost done. I can get through it. I'm not quite sure how many more pages of this one I've got to do. It might only be those three there. I'll flick through later and work it out. But yeah, I'm almost done on that one. And another one I want to finish for the year is another Color Questopia one. And this one is Space. And I did four in this one. So you've got the Spaceman. You got Spaceman again. again, it was one where I used the colors. It says, but if I didn't have the exact color out of the set I'm trying to use up, I've used something close or I thought would be a decent substitute. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, I had all of the right colors. This one, I did do two different colors for the background. And as you can see very clearly, I did it as a checkerboard. I did two different types of blue just to vary it up. But otherwise, with this book, you find that the backgrounds are all either a lot of black or a lot of navy blue. So I wanted to give it a bit more of a variant. And I think I did the same with some of the planets. I didn't do it exactly as the colors it wanted. I did close proximities. And this was the last one. And with all of them, again, it was the water-based markers. I have a pencil case full of mystery ones from different packs and the alcohol markers I wanted to use up. And for this one, I also used the paint pens to put just big white blobs for stars. So, yeah, not sure how many. I think I got, this one, I've got a lot more pages to do to get it finished, but I aim to get it finished by the end of the year. So they were all of the color by number books. Next we'll do the full coloring, and this is again a book I want to finish by the end of the year, so you will see this one in quite a few of the videos because I want to get it done. It is the Far Out Space Adventure book. Now, I did three. Now, with this one, I mentioned it when I showed it last month, and you can sort of see it here, how I have a alcohol marker set that's all different grays. And I did two, like the blue gray and the green grays last month. Well, I continued that for this month with the other grays in the set I hadn't used. So this page was colored in with all of the ones that were labeled as cool grays. And I really do like the way these gray ones come out. And that's the back of it. Yeah, I don't know why. I just think the gray ones look really cool. In some ways better than the ones that I've done with full colors. So yeah, guess it's just personal preference. This one was done with the markers labeled warm and neutral grays. Again, that's your back there. I'm happy with this one too. I like the way these look. They make it look more moody, I think. And lastly was this one, and these were the ones that were labeled yellow and red grays. And that's your back. So yeah, that was the last of the greys in that grey pack. So I've used all of them. So now I'll have to go back to doing different colour palettes to do the rest of the book. But yeah, I do. Again, I'm happy with all of these ones. I do love the way the greys come out and look. And yeah, expect to see more of this book because it is one I'm also aiming to finish by the end of the year. This one is also one I'm aiming to finish by the end of the year. It has actually come loose from its cover. As you can see, it's not quite where it needs to be sitting, but that's okay. The pages themselves are together, and that's the main thing. So for this one, I did 4, I believe. And this is the glitter colouring book. So there's parts of the pages that are textured. So when you colour it in, it gives it a different look. The other thing with this book is I use either alcohol markers or Sharpies only in it. And boy, does it give off a smell. So that's a warning if you ever do get this book and you use Sharpies or alcohol markers. It really does smell. And I don't know if it's the chemical reaction with the parts that are the glitter or what, but they always, it really, really smells. So moving on from that, I did this one. Now I think, is this a lima? I think it's a lima. And this would be alcohol mark, no, Sharpies. So I used Sharpies on this one. I did the eagle here. Sharpies, I might have used Sharpies for all of them for the month. Just picked up my pencil case with all my Sharpies in it and just got it done. This lion, yep, Sharpies again. I stuck to sort of purples and pinks and yellows on this one by the looks of things. And lastly, this beaver. Let me guess, Sharpie, yeah, Sharpies again. So I used Sharpies on all of these for the month. So that was that one. 2 more books to go. These books I'm not trying to get finished by the end of the year or anything, so they're a nice variety. There's this Kawaii Kitties colouring, and I did 3. And of course, being kitties and kawaii, it fits in with my spooky Japan cats theme. So I did this gorgeous big-eyed kitty. I made him orange. Now I used the Artline Sticks brush markers. They are water-based and I really like them. I think they're designed for kids, but they're these ones. I've got one handy next to me. It's these ones. This is the drawing pen, but they all look like this sort of body, and I just love them because they're textured and they feel good to hold and color. So yeah, I really like that set. As I said, again, I think they are designed for children, but I don't care. I like them. And they have nice colours in them as well. The next one I did was this one. Now, this one was a full page of this weird sort of abstract cat pattern. But what I did was with the black marker is just colour in some sort of border and a little bit throughout the image as well to sort of give shape to certain other shapes, to give it a more defined shape is probably what I should be saying there. Now what did I, these are alcohol markers. Yeah, this is all done with alcohol markers. And I'm happy with this one. It's an, as I said, an abstract drawing. So some of it was a bit hard to try and work out what was happening, especially like with the fish. And I did them in a dark purple, so you can't really see very well that there's little fish heads and eyes and stuff. But the rest of it, I liked it. It's nice that they're not all the same sort of drawing in here as well. They are all different styles of image. So, yeah, you can pick what you feel like doing on a particular day. And the last one I did from this book was this one. Now, I think this is all alcohol markers as well. Yes, it is. So, yeah, I just did the background in a light pastel pink. And, yeah, just whatever alcohol markers I had to your hand. And you can see that some of them were, they're definitely drying up and almost, I think I did throw this one out after I finished the cat, but I don't mind it on this sort of image when it's an animal because it gives it like a fur texture or, you know, a skin texture. So I was really quite okay with it being almost out. And this is the idea. This is why I want to use them up. So they were the three from Kawaii Kitties. Now, the last book is one that's a sweary one. This is the Busy Transcending Bullshit Colouring Book from Sugar and Sloth. Now, Sugar and Sloth, I believe, are an English company. I got an anxiety kit given to me from a friend who also got me these books. So, yeah, they've got some really cool stuff. And they're just such simple and fun things to colour in. Like, you don't have to overthink it at all. So, I did three from here. And this is the first one. Holy fuck balls, I'm tough as hell. So, as you can see, it's just a lot of white space, which I really just loosely coloured in very loosely with a grey marker and did the rest of it. So I'm pretty sure this might have been alcohol markers, yeah, and gel pens. So for the writing, I'm pretty sure I used gel pens, and the actual jellyfish, I used the alcohol markers in the background. And I'm pretty sure the three, I'll know when I look at the other two, the three I picked for the month were all sort of reflecting different moods I was having at different stages. And yeah, things came up and I thought, well, yeah, I am tough as hell because I'm still surviving and getting through things no matter, you know, how hard they get. This one, because I do, as you know, if you've watched the channel for a while, suffer from anxiety, and I saw this and thought, definitely so relate, because your anxiety is a lying dickhead. So if you do suffer from anxiety, I hope you get something out of this message. Again, I used gel pens for the words and the stripe on the prawn, and I drew a few extra bubbles so that some of the white space was taken up, and they were all coloured in with glitter gel pens, and the prawn itself was done with alcohol marker. And the last one, this one definitely applied for the month, and with this one I used the Tombow dual brush markers, I'm pretty sure, yep, good memory, and alcohol markers. So I did very nice bright rainbow with the Tombow markers, a very light background with the alcohol marker, and I think the unicorn was also done. Well, it's not really a unicorn, it doesn't have a horn, so the horsey. The beautiful colourful horsey was done with alcohol marker as well. So, love the colour. These Tombow ones, so vibrant. Really, really pretty. So, yeah, there they all were. My completed projects and colouring pages for the month of April. Now, stay tuned because I will be showing your entries also for Spooky Japan Cats _ April, and May will be up and running by the time this video is showing. So continue sending through those entries. Just change the month at the end so that's applicable to what month we're in. I really do appreciate everyone joining in. And again, it's open to all crafts, arts, and hobbies. But that's it from me. So thank you all for watching. Let me know what you thought of these items. I love to hear from you and I always respond. And if you can't think of anything to say, just leave an emoji and I'll respond in kind. If this is your first time stumbling across my channel, or if you've watched for a number of videos and haven't done so yet, please subscribe. It helps out the channel and I am forever grateful. Also hit that like button and the notification bell so you're up to date when I've released my latest video. If you're interested in supporting the channel further, I do have a Ko-fi and a Patreon account set up and the details are up here on screen. Currently, if you are a patron, you get a monthly file from myself, something like a PNG or a JPEG or a PDF of a colouring page I've designed or of a sticker design, something to that effect, cards around Christmas time, things like that. So you do get a benefit for being a member and you also get your name at the end of the video. But that will do it from me. So everybody, until next time, please stay safe, stay weird, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!